All right, so this is Christian Robinson, and this is my DNA results. I decided to use two different DNA companies. I use 23andMe, and I use Ancestry.com. So 23andMe.com and Ancestry.com, both are different. They have, you know, the DNA kit was similar. It was pretty much identical process far as how I got the DNA to them, but their website and the kind of things that they kind of, I won't say promote, but the focus is sort of different. So the experience is different, where Ancestry is kind of based around finding your family tree and finding relatives, whereas 23andMe is more like research and you know, it's just a different vibe. The websites are different in nature. So the 23andMe, I haven't found a place to add a tree. So it allows you to link to a tree that you have existing. So I basically link my Ancestry tree that I started to the 23andMe link. So the main reason why I did this DNA test is to see what I am, like, you know, what nationality I'm comprised of. Is it only African American? Maybe I can find what tribe I was from. Maybe I'm mixed with Indian. I don't know. I think it's some Indian in our family. So I really just wanted to know that. I really didn't do it to connect with family members. However, someone did connect with me who is supposed to be a distant cousin of mine, who actually reached out to me. So I'll deal with that, you know, after. I'll deal with that later. But yeah, someone, a lady, an older lady, basically reached out to me, and we could be possibly related to each other, which is a good thing. All right, so I've never seen a DNA results video, so I really don't know what to do, so I'm just gonna go for it. I'm gonna probably lean toward Ancestry.com first, and then go to 23andMe, or I'll try to do both at the same time. So 23andMe was finished days ago. It was already, the results were already in. I remember I sent them in at the same time, and 23andMe was already finished. The results was there. So I had to be patient because I wanted to do them at the same time. And so today I got the message that Ancestry.com was completed. So I'm going to click on DNA tab on Ancestry and see what we can do. Your DNA result summary. So I have notes that I'm going to write down because I'm not going to remember everything. So I'm going to write the notes as I go. All right. It says 21% Nigeria, 18% Cameroon, Congo, and Western Bantu peoples, and 14 other regions, whatever that means. 1,000 plus fourth cousins or closer. So we're gonna look at the story, then we're gonna look at the matches, and true lines use ancestry trees to suggest how you may relate it to DNA matches through common ancestor. So I don't know what that one is about. So I'm going to turn this music down just a hair. All right. So let's look at this DNA for me. Okay. So I have okay. Now that makes sense with the lady. Wow. That makes sense because the lady that hit me up, I believe her relative or something was from Nigeria, which makes 100% sense. So I'll be able to relay that information to her as well. So here we go. So I'm going to write down I'm going to write down that I am 21% from Nigeria. And that I am 18% Cameroon, Congo, and Western Bantu peoples. So that's my heritage, according to the DNA. Which is, you know, I had no idea, right? There was no way for me to know that. Not with my family, passing down our, you know, genetic tree or our family history. There was no way that I would have known this. Okay, so I accidentally had the song on repeat, so we're gonna move on to the next song. All right, so it says 14 other regions. I don't know what that means. I'm gonna hit the plus sign and see what that means. So obviously there's more. It says, great news, Christian, your results have arrived. Your results include ethnicity breakdown, your DNA story, and your DNA matches. So we're just gonna go along with this. We're gonna go to the next step. Oh, so now it tells me everything. I see Scotland somewhere in there. Wow, okay, so here we go. And I wonder if this all adds up to 100. Okay, results with a color indicate distant origins 500 to 1,000 years ago. Results with this symbol indicates more recent origins 50 to 300 years ago. Okay, so the solid ones are the ones that I'm stating now, the solid ones. So that's a long time ago, 500 to 1,000 years ago. Okay, so I'm gonna put that. So that's probably where my origins really were from, which was Nigeria, Cameroon, Congo, and Western Bantu. And then I see Mali. Mali says 17%. Senegal, 8%. Ivory Coast and Ghana, 8%. Benin and Togo. People pronounce that differently. 6%. Scotland, 6%. England and Northwestern Europe. So I have some European blood in me. 4%. Norway, 3%. Nigeria, East Central, 2%. Ireland, 2%. Eastern Bantu people, opposed to the Western, 1%. Caucasian, I don't know how to pronounce that, aka the Mbuti people, Mbuti peoples, France, 1%, Spain, 1%, and Wales, 1%. Okay, so the DNA communities are early Virginia African Americans, East Texas, Arkansas, and Louisiana African Americans. That sounds about right. Mississippi and Alabama African Americans. Southwest Alabama African Americans. The Carolinas, Maryland, and Virginia African Americans. Upstate and North Central South Carolina African Americans. Let me see. Let me see if these colors are correlating. So I think the colors on the bottom correlates to the ones on the top. So that's green, Mississippi and Alabama African Americans came from Nigeria. I think that's what it's trying to say. I'm not 100% sure how to read this chart. All right, so we're going to move on. So let me write down one more. So the seven, so the Molly says 17%. So really, it's throwing a lot of numbers at me, which I really don't know what these numbers mean. There's no definitive answer to say, this is where you're from, this is where your people are from. I'm just getting percentages of, so it's saying there's a possibility you're from here, and this is the percentage of the possibility. I would have loved to have something more definitive. I can't be from 15 different places from at one time. All right, so let me try to catch up with using 23andMe. So let's see Ancestry. Start with your Ancestry. So let's go with the Ancestry and let's see if we get some similarity in the matches. That's what I was trying to do, is compare the two. So this one is telling me Ancestry composition, DNA relatives list. You share DNA with 1,500 other 23andMe customers. And then there's one close relative. And I wonder if that's my sister. I don't know if that's my sister or not. Traits, Neanderthal ancestry, which I studied that in college. Maternal haplogroup. Your haplogroup shared with speakers of the Bantu language family traces the long line of women in your family tree. And see, this one says something about Bantu. So this one says Bantu, and Ancestry says Western Bantu peoples. Maternal and then paternal. What do you and speakers of the Bantu language family have in common? An ancient common ancestor on the paternal line. View the report. What is the story of your DNA? Oh, so it's like a book you can create. They're always looking for a way to monetize. You could probably give that as a gift, maybe. All right, so let's go with the first one, view the report. So let's see what the percentages. So here we go. So now this is giving me different information than the other one. This one is saying sub-Saharan African. It says 80%. Let me see something here. Okay, so I kind of understand what's going on now. I have 4% Filipino in me. I have 2% East Asian in me. All right, so the sub-Saharan African, it says 81%. West African, 71%. Okay. Ghanaian, Liberian, and Sierra Leonean, 26.7. Now, I don't see none of that in Nigeria. Let's see, Nigeria. Yeah, so I see the Nigeria. It says Nigeria East Central for Ancestry. It says 2%. Over here, it says Nigerian 26.3%. So that's why it's hard for me to understand what's going on between the two. Senegambian, Senegambian, and Ghanaian. Guinean, not Ghanaian, but Guinean. I don't know how to pronounce that. It says 6%. And broadly West African, it says that I'm 11%. Congolese and Southern East Africa, African, 10%. Angolian and Congolese, 8%. Southwestern East African, 0.4%, which is, I'm assuming that's going to be small. Broadly, Congolese and Southern East Africa, 1.4%. So that was from Africa. Now this one is dealing with European. It says Northwestern European, I have 17.7%. Period. And see, so one number that I was giving was just a subset of something else. Now that I'm reading it differently, let me see. Hold on. I'm trying to see how they fold here. Okay, so when I say West African, then everything that I was listing under that was a part of that 71%. So 26 is a part of that 71%. Nigerian 26 was a part of that 80, that West African. So it broke it down. So let me start all over. So it says Sub-Saharan African 81%, and then it breaks that down by West African and then Congolese and Southern East African 10%. So when you start adding this up, all those will add up to 81%. And I was just reading the sub parts of West Africa and the sub parts of Southeastern East African. All right, so let's go on to European, which the total of that, of what I'm about to list, is 17.7. And it includes Northwestern European, British and Irish, 16.2%, French and German. I have 0.9% French and German in me, so I can't talk about Germans because I got a little German in me according to my DNA. Let's see. I'm trying to see where it says European over here. France, Spain. Okay, anyway. All right, so I'm trying to understand how what to make of all these numbers. And then it says broadly Northwestern European 0.6%. So those are small percentage. French and German 0.9%, which is small. Broadly Northwestern European 0.6%, even smaller. All right, so indigenous American, which is, I think, don't get me lying, it should tell me what that means. Let me see. So I'm clicking on the link so I don't offend nobody. Your DNA suggests that 0.5 of your ancestry is indigenous American. Since the immemorial, humans have called the Americans home from the wind-battered islands of southern Patagonia to the gently rolling tundra of the North American Arctic. Humans have lived in North America alongside now extinct mammoth, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so I'm trying to figure out. I don't want it. Give me some background of stuff. I'm trying to get to the point where it's telling me, okay, so I'm trying to click on the right link here. So let me see if it's color code. So I see the color code here. So the yellow is covering Canada, United States, Mexico, Bolivia, Paraguay, Greenland. That's what it's calling Indigenous American. And then the African was in the African region is colored similar. And then the blue is European. And that's dealing with United Kingdom, Sweden, Finland, Germany, France, Australia, Iceland. So I'm just trying to learn how to read this chart here. It's kind of confusing a little bit. All right, so it says trace ancestry 0.6%. We detected trace of the following population in your DNA. Read more about trace ancestry in the fact sheet. Filipino and Austronesian, 0.4%. Broadly East Asian, 0.2%. And then there is an unassigned, which it says 0.2%. See all tested populations. Don't know what that means. Let's see. Okay, so it's showing me everything all at once. Okay. Reference data sets, let's see. I guess this is the data sets is telling me, I'm assuming how many people match that. I'm guessing. I don't know how to read this thing. This table shows the number of reference individuals used to define each ancestry population. The reference data sets are made up of individuals from publicly available data sets, including Human Genome Diversity Project, HapMap, and the 1000 Genomes Project, as well as individuals from private 23andMe data collections and larger number of 23andMe customers who have consented to participate in the research. In total, there are 12,400 research consent customers and 2,412 non-customers in the population reference. All right, so we could look at my results. So it just looks like I'm 80% sub-Saharan African, whatever that means. I'm 17% European. I am less than 0.5% Indigenous American. So I wasn't born in America per se, right? So my origin is pretty much Africa. Trace ancestry, okay? So that's what I'm getting from that. I think someone said this one was more straightforward, the 23andMe, you can kind of read it more straightforward than the ancestry, and I think that's I'm proving that now. All right, so now that we did that, I'm gonna go back a step. So that was the composition. Okay, so I know I'm from African descent, but I didn't know from what regions, right? Ancestry, okay. I'm clicking on this Ancestry timeline. So 1880 was Nigerian, Ghanaian, Liberian, and Sierra Leone, British, and Irish. So I might have, you know, people back then, I might have British and Irish blood in me, period. People were mixing, you know, the races were mixing, so. 1820, Angolian and Congolese, Senegambian and Ghanaian, French and German, and then in 1790, indigenous American and Southern East African. So I guess it's saying, okay, I could be wrong. It's just saying that relatives of mine were far back as 1880. And some of my relatives were British and Irish. Some of my relatives were Ghanaian and Liberian. That's how I'm reading this. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 different. Well, 1, 2, 3 different time zones where my relatives come from. That's how I read it. Let's look at parental inheritance. Don't know what that means. Oh, who got what? Okay. How much of each ancestry did you inherit? Okay. I understand. I used to do these charts in college. So the purple is my mom. And the blue is my father. Connect a parent onto it to see that. Or connect with your child. Okay. There's nothing to write here. It's just some colors. It's just my mom is purple. And it looks like I got more traits from my father far as the chunk of the pie. That's how I'm reading this. But I really don't know what, it's not saying what the traits are. It's not saying what how much of each ancestry did you inherit from your parents? So I guess I got more from my father's side than my mother. I guess that's what that it's saying, but it's not giving me much information there. DNA painting. Let's see. All right. So now it's basically giving me how DNA looks. It's breaking it down of how it looked. All right. Anyway, so let's go. So that was 23andMe experience. So the next thing for 23 would be the relative list, and we'll do that in a minute. All right, so let's see what else can I see. I'm gonna go to next on the ancestry.com and see what I can see. First of all, I didn't write anything far as my ancestry on 23. Let's see what notes I can write. So Saharan African. So what I can do, you know, is I can look this stuff up myself. I'm sure it probably has some of this stuff on this site, but I can just look it up on other sources of where these places are and whatever, you know. So European, so we'll say I'm 17% European. So somebody was doing something, you know, with my relative. That's what, I might be reading that wrong, but that's what it seems like to me. So I have some European blood in me. That's, I don't know if I'm saying that right. And indigenous American is only 5%, 0.5%. Indigenous American. All right. And nothing from those two sites have the same information, right? They break it down differently. Nigerian. So the only thing that I see here that is the same is Nigerian. This one, Ancestry says I'm 21% Nigerian, but this one says 26.3%, but not out of 100, but out of the West African. So it's just hard to explain. It's hard to read these charts, to be honest with you. I'm just going to be honest. It's hard to just say, hey, I'm 5% this, 20% that. I know that I'm African American, so that wasn't a big shock, right? So, but this stuff is just breaking down pretty much where my relatives are from. All right, so let's go to next on Ancestry. All right, you can explore, blah, blah, blah. Early Virginia African Americans, let's see. 1750, 1775. You share early Virginia African American communities with 61 of your DNA matches. Matches are other people you have who have taken Ancestry DNA tests who you might be related to. Wow. 61. So we're going to write that down. 61. Matches. So I might be related to 61 different people. Let's see. So hopefully they have contact information and blah, blah, blah. And, you know, I'm sure that not everybody's going to have contact information where I can contact them. Let's see here. I'm trying to figure out. Okay, so that's the list. So I'm going to click on list. Since it's saying 61 DNA matches, I'm just going to click on relatives on the 23andMe and see what happens. Wow. Now it's listing them. Now it's listing names, okay? Wow. Showing 1,500. Your predicted family tree is now available. As we grow, your predicted relationship to close relatives may have become more accurate. So now 23andMe did an automatic tree for me. So I'm gonna click on the tree and see what happens. Wow. So it's a lot. That's a lot. 1,500. So now it giving me a tree. Wow. Welcome to your family tree. Your tree predicts your close relatives based on your ages and shared DNA. Select other possible relationships on each relative to learn other relationships that share the same range of DNA. Hit next. Build and edit your tree. Fill in the ancestors. Edit relationships and add new relatives. Click the circle to begin. Done. Unplaced relatives. Our algorithm was unable to place some of your close relatives with sufficient confidence to view and add additional relatives. Visit your DNA relatives list. Okay. All right. So it's basically giving me a list of who's who. and who they are to me. So to give you an example, so let's see, I'm clicking on one, unknown relative, unknown parent, add a relative. Okay, so now I can add my mom here and I can add my father name here. Okay, so it says Bianca King, second cousin twice removed, Christopher Frazier, second cousin once removed, Robert Jones, second cousin, Fancy M, first cousin once removed. So that's going to give me more information. Like, that will give me, I don't know which one of these icons is my mother or my father, but that will give me my mother's or father's parents and my grandparents. It'll help me fill in the blanks that I don't have. Then on the other side, I don't know which side is which, is which side is my, is the father's side, which side is the mother's side, but it says Teresa Salas, third cousin, Michael Martin, once cousin, excuse me, first cousin once removed, Louis Jackson, first cousin, Kay Scott, second cousin once removed, Isaac Towns, second cousin once removed, and Isaac Towns, second cousin once removed. So why did it have the same name twice? So it has same name twice, Isaac, spelled the same way. So it has one name twice. Okay. Family tree. Let's see. Okay, let's click on one. Let's click on Bianca. Predicted second twice. Edit. See other possible view profile. So I'm gonna come up with some type of response to everybody and say, you know, hello, blah blah blah. I use this such and such service, and it's apparent that we share some DNA. Would you like to connect or something to that effect? You know, it even has a connect button there. I'm not gonna do it yet, but it has a button. So my mother, I know who my grandmother was. So my grandmother's so this is not that far from my cousin. These are not far away. My great grandparents. I remember who my great grandmother was. So this is my second cousin. And let me see, Bianca King. Her name doesn't sound familiar. Her name doesn't sound familiar, you know, but we're gonna get to the bottom of this. Cause if they know who mommy is and they know who Bill is, then we are on the right track here. Christopher Frazier. Let's see. He's in California. And it's second cousin. So it's also close. So this person is also close to me. Wow. Oh, and I didn't scroll down. It's given a percentage of the likelihood that we are related. He's 84% sub-Saharan African. He's 11% less than me European. He's more indigenous American 2.1 than I am. Let me see. So we're not directly connected through a female ancestries. that it predict. You have more Neanderthal variants than Christopher has more Neanderthal than, huh? You have more Neanderthal variants than 1% of the customers. Christopher has the same thing, 1%. Okay. Okay, let's see. It says find relatives in common. Wow. And now it shows all the relatives that, wow. DNA overlap. Connect to view. Wow. I got a lot of work to do because it's like I'm connected to a lot of people on 23andMe. Like, it's a lot, man. I mean, can you imagine if we had a family reunion with DNA match? It would be a convention. Strength of relationship, percentage related, segment newest let's go percentage. Okay, so all the rest of them are not likely, but the ones on top are most likely. So it's most likely that Lewis Jackson is my first cousin, 12.64 DNA, shared 34 segments. Let's see. Showing ancestry results, favorites. Showing ancestry results. Oh, okay. So all of them are not showing ancestry results. That's what that means. Mother's father's side. Let's see, share with your mother or father to see maternal. Ancestry birthplace. Connections, connected, pending, not connected, okay. Family names. So we have a lot of family names. Johnson, Smith, Brown, Williams, Jones, Davis, Taylor, Jackson, White, Harris, Moore. Oh Lord, I hope I didn't date one of my relatives. Moore, Wilson, Lee, Miller, Scott, Anderson, Thomas, Martin. That my uncle's name is Martin. Last name is Martin. Let's click this Moore. I'm worried about that one. Let's see. Oh Lord, I don't want to. I might not want to know this. I'm just trying to make sure my ex-girlfriend's name not on here. Ooh wee. All right. A little jokey joke there. So I have 1,500 for 23andMe. I'm gonna be a very busy person, and then 61 for now remember they're not all strong matches, so I guess 23andMe is just showing you all of them. So let's see, percentage rate, so segment shared and newest relatives. So here go the newest relatives. And that is 1,500. So it's just putting it in a certain order. All right. So the 23andMe gave me way more to play with, right? Now let's go back to Ancestry. It says you and 61 of your DNA matches, along with 83,000 other ancestry, blah, 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 are genetically linked to this region through shared ancestry. Okay. Oh, no, that was just saying what from Virginia that we are connected to early Virginia. Let's see. All right. So let's go to relatives. Let's see. DNA matches. There we go. So I'm trying to go to the equivalent of what I found with 23andMe. And I want to see how many match the other list. And that's going to trip me out if I see somebody that I recognize. I think it's good to know who you relative to, because I could have dated accidentally one of my relatives, right? Because you don't know. It would be totally by accident, but it still could have happened. Now, it didn't, it's a long list of people, but it didn't tell me how many here. So it gave me my matches, but I would like to know the total of the matches. It doesn't give me the total. It says sort. It's a long list, but it didn't give me. Man, it's a long list. It could be 1500 like the other one, but it's not saying, hey, this is the total results. So what I can do is, once I look for one over here, I can cross it with the list over here to see how accurate they are. I can take this list with the number and then go down the line. I mean, it's a job, you know what I'm saying? You know, to go through each one and contact each one. Let me see here. Unviewed. All right, good. So that's unviewed. Good. Common ancestors. Let's see. Common ancestors. No matches. View all your matches. Common ancestors. View all your matches. Okay. Messages. There shouldn't be any messages. Okay. Notes. Shouldn't be any notes. Trees. All trees, let's see, all trees. Share DNA, here we go. R, wow, it says. Okay, so all matches is 18,761. I have, that's how many matches I have. That's a lot. 18,761. Matches, okay. Close matches, fourth cousin or closer, 1515. So this one had 1501, okay. 23andMe says 1500, right? And then this one is saying close matches, fourth cousin or closer, 1515. So that's about right, right? Wow, so let's go with the close matches. So in my mind, they should be similar, right? Some of these people are on this list. Some of these people should be on this list. Ebella, so let's try that. So we sort close to distant. First cousin, Ebella. So let's do a search here. Ebella. I'm going the opposite direction. I'm trying to see if someone from Ancestry is on 23andMe. I'm just playing around here. So I didn't find anybody with that name. Let's try Bella. Nothing. Okay. Leah Robinson. That's my Robinson is my last name. All right, let's try that. Let's start with last names. Fourth cousins. So we're going to use search, match name, first name, last name, or username. Robinson. Leah Robinson. Let me see. It's not giving me an exact match over here. Let's see if we can do an exact match. Robinson, in quotes, nothing. Nothing. So even though, like, Lewis Jackson came up, even though I wrote Robinson, so I don't understand why is that. So I'm clicking on it to figure out why it says Robinson there. Oh, family surnames. That's why. That's why. Okay, so Relaford. Oh, Lord. I know a guy named Relaford. Oh, Lord. What if me and Relaford is related? Oh, Lord. Regina Robinson. What if me and Relaford... what if me and Pastor Relaford is related to each other? All right, so we're gonna kill the search. See, this one says to do family names. I don't want it to do. See, the other one didn't give me an opportunity. All right, so a lot of these are just, it says cousins, you know. It's not getting any closer than that. Let's see. By ads, all matches. Welcome to True Life. True Life makes it easier for them. Let's see. I'm trying to figure something. Oh, it's telling where people live. Hold on. DMA matches by where people live. Okay, so I can see where the people live in the world. Throughout the world, okay? Most of them are in the United States, but no, yeah. Most of them are from the United States. Let's see. Your location spotted on the mission, blah blah blah. Los Angeles. Let me see.
Your location is plotted from the information you provided on your public, which you can change anytime or update or remove your pin. Okay. So it's showing me where everybody lives. Like maybe in real time or where they say they're from. So let's see how many people are from close by. Okay. So I have four Los Angeles, okay. Okay, Alethea Briggs, Kim Jones, Michael Potterfield Jr., and David Moore. God, Lord, he looked familiar. Not family-wise, but I think I've seen his face somewhere. Now, so far, just glancing, these names are not matching up, right? So let's say Alethea. So that's kind of, tripping me out, because how can you have people matching you on one but not matching on the other? See? So that's a little confusing. So I'm going to try percentage related. And it's basically saying cousins. Back to matches, let's see. Close family. So I'm back on Ancestry. So I have three first cousins here and three first cousins here. And none of them are connected. All right, so none of them are similar. Priscilla Harvey. See? So that's kind of, okay, let's see. Rosalind Harvey, ooh, that was my girlfriend's first name. I'm about to jump. I was about to jump, like, oh, wait. Priscilla Leah Robinson. I'm just going with the first cousin. Ebella. All right, so this video, it's an hour long, so that's part one. So I'm going to stop the video for part one and start a part two, so the videos won't be so long.